Yeah. So let's go back and talk about Fred Hoyle for a moment. What was his role in discovering some of those fine-tuning parameters and how one of them rocked his worldview and led him to abandon atheism and affirm the existence of some kind of super intellect behind the universe? First of all, who was Sir Frederick Hoyle, and what role did he play discovering some of the most important fine-tuning parameters?
Well, you'll remember we encountered Sir Fred Hoyle, Professor Hoyle, in the previous discussion of the Big Bang.
That's right.
Because he formulated an alternative hypothesis to the Big Bang because he was, as he put it, metaphysically opposed to the idea that the universe should have a beginning. He was quite explicit that he thought the Big Bang had clear theistic implications. He was a committed philosophical naturalist or atheist.
Very committed.
And so he wanted to come up with a theory that would preserve his naturalistic, no-God worldview. And the steady state was the theory he came up with, later refuted by the discovery of the cosmic background radiation, which we discussed in a previous episode. But Hoyle was very committed initially in his career to that philosophical perspective, of a more materialistic or atheistic perspective. But he was working in the 1950s on trying to explain a puzzle that greatly interested him, which was, how do we explain the abundance of carbon in our universe? And for all intents and purposes, he realized that carbon was essential for life. Carbon forms long chain-like molecules that can store information. For example, in the DNA molecule, it stores information and it has a lot of carbon in it. So he realized that carbon was essential for life, but it was very hard to conceive how carbon might have originated. And the standard way of thinking about the origination of heavy chemical elements was that they would gain elementary particles one at a time and gradually build from simple elements like hydrogen and helium up to more complex elements like carbon. Carbon has an atomic weight of 12. And so I've got a little graphic to show that shows the problem. And there was a term of art that the physicists came up with to describe the problem. They called it the five nucleon crevasse. And what they realized was that if you added a proton or a neutron, protons and neutrons are also called nucleons. So if you add one of those things one at a time, you can get from hydrogen to helium, no problem. But then if you add one more proton or neutron and have an element with five nucleons, those are highly unstable, and they fall apart very quickly. They have a very short half-life. So it was really hard to imagine how you got from helium with an atomic weight of 4 to carbon with an atomic weight of 12. So one theory was, we'll combine 3 helium molecules, each with atomic weight 4, and we'll get to 12. But getting 3 to collide all at the same time was astronomically improbable, and no one thought that was plausible. So Hoyle came up with the idea that, well, maybe you could get 2 heliums to combine to make a beryllium, atomic weight 8, and then that beryllium would separately combine with a helium. And then you'd get a carbon molecule, atomic weight 12. Voila, problem solved, except for one thing. When he did the calculations on the energies associated with those constituent parts of a carbon,
right,
he found that the resulting carbon had an energy level that was above the energy level of the carbons we most typically observe. And it had a precise value, 7.65 MeV. And so he went out to Caltech, and he pigeonholed a physicist out there named Willie Fowler. And he said, would you do some experiments of nuclear, basically nuclear physics experiments, to see if you can find a carbon that has this excited energy level called a resonance? And we found some actual audio recordings of interactions between Hoyle and these guys, and Willie Fowler talking about what a nut job he thought Hoyle was at first. But he was finally persuaded to do the experiment, and lo and behold, he found a carbon with exactly that resonance, the one that Hoyle had predicted with that level of precision. They were blown away. And Hoyle was blown away because it implied very difficult to make carbon, but there is a way to do it.